At today's press conference, Sean Spicer conflated the unsubstantiated claims that BuzzFeed released with what CNN reported. And I was surprised by that because he said BuzzFeed and CNN made the decision to run with the unsubstantiated claim. That's simply not true. I mean, what CNN said is that CNN is not reporting on details of that memo, as it has not independently corroborated the specific allegations. Do you acknowledge here and now that CNN did not release the 35-page unsubstantiated claims against Donald Trump and it was misleading and untrue for Sean Spicer to suggest otherwise?
No, our incoming press secretary, Sean Spicer, was exactly right, as was the president-elect Anderson. CNN went first yesterday, and BuzzFeed went second.
We didn't report CNN what released. BuzzFeed reported.
I didn't say that you did, but you linked
Sean
to
Spicer
it
said
in your story.
We did.
Let me just tell you, Anderson, let's back up. I know CNN must be feeling the heat today of having a headline yesterday at around 6:30 p.m. that said, quote, Intel chiefs presented Trump with information that Russia could compromise. Russia had information to compromise him. That is just false. And as you saw through NBC News reports today, tweets from people at Politico, no friend of Donald Trump, and a lot of, frankly, a lot of outlets, print and electronic outlets, so reluctant and hesitant to go forward with anything close to what CNN or BuzzFeed did.
Well,
I know you
again,
want to distance yourself from BuzzFeed, but you went first.
But
no,
you're
I'm conflating nothing.
What BuzzFeed...
I just know what CNN did. Anderson, you know, you're a responsible journalist. You've gone all over the world. You're widely respected.
What's inaccurate about what CNN reported?
Oh, my goodness, the whole headline. Go read the entire story. Four bylines and a story that's just not true, that the president-elect was presented with this information, that it was appended in a two-page document to the briefing. NBC has said it was not. Other people have said it was
NBC
not.
Has said
now
it NBC has said it was not verbally presented, and CNN never said it was verbally presented. In fact, we said, CNN in their reporting, based on multiple sources, said we don't know if it was verbally presented. What CNN said was, and I quote, classified documents presented last week to President Obama and President-elect Trump included allegations that Russian operatives claimed to have compromising personal and financial information about Mr. Trump. Multiple U.S. officials with direct knowledge of the briefings tell CNN.
Anderson, your sources are not correct. And the fact is
so that you're saying
I
in that intelligence,
are you
telling me, you're saying in that intelligence briefing, there was no information in any of the documents of that two-page summary.
So two things on that. Number one, we don't discuss the classified information that is presented in intelligence briefings.
Well, you just said
that's
it wasn't
why they're
true.
Closed door. Excuse me, but Anderson, if you want me to talk, I know CNN is feeling the heat today. But
I think
I was
you
gracious
guys are feeling
enough
the
to come
heat.
On and discuss it. We feel what heat do we feel that you've got this raw information, this complete ridiculous fake news. Actually, it's just fake. It's not
it's actually
even
been
news.
Backed
I
up by not only multiple
words.
Sources, but
no,
but
hasn't.
Other news agencies, New York Times,
okay,
Washington.
Okay, well, I'm surprised you
so
just want to argue with me. It has not been backed up by credible news sources. And you know as well as I do that these rumors were running around for months. Every news outlet was chasing these rumors Anderson, because CNN went first and had this breathless report. You know, everybody said it was a bombshell, earth-shattering report last night.
We didn't say it was
BuzzFeed
a bombshell.
BuzzFeed then went ahead. But yes, he did. Yes, he did. It says right here, Intel chiefs presented Trump with claims of Russian effort to compromise him.
Where's
that's
the word bombshell?
That's not true. Your headline is wrong. Well, then Seth Meyer said that he confronted me on the bombshell. None of it is true.
Well,
and I think can you tell me, would you run the same story today, knowing what you know, everything that's happened?
Because absolutely.
You would, wow, because the executive editor of the New York Times said they saw this information and decided they couldn't
corroborate,
they couldn't verify it.
They're talking about the BuzzFeed story.
And so are you. You linked to the,
We said we cannot corroborate. We're not reporting what they released. In fact, Jake Tapper has been very critical of what BuzzFeed has done.
If you couldn't corroborate it, why would you even link to it? Why are you linking to fake news?
We did
why
not
are you linking
link to it.
Stuff? You know the Michael Cohen who is mentioned in that report is not the Michael Cohen who works at the Trump Organization. This Michael
we
Cohen,
never
Michael
said
D.
he
Cohen,
was.
Has never been. You're linking to the BuzzFeed report. You
We're
guys
not linking to the BuzzFeed
updated.
Report.
It's mentioned in here. I'm looking at the updated CNN report. I read it right before we came on air. And absolutely, you know, people are going why did you run a story? Why run a story based on anonymous sourcing that now has been rebutted about a two-page appendix that
so you're saying
not,
there was no
true.
You're saying that there was no two-page summary that was included in briefing materials.
the president-elect was asked that question today, you should refer to his answer. But I will tell you.
Well, no, you can answer lower it. Level, he said.
No, I wasn't in the briefing.
Okay, so you can't say whether or not. You're saying it's not true, but you're saying also
what
you can't.
What did the president-elect say today when he was asked?
I don't know. You tell me.
Well, then you didn't pay attention to the attention to the press conference. You're relying on CNN, on verified sources.
Actually, I just watched the press conference. I just don't want to misquote the president-elect. I assume you know what the president-elect said today.
I sure do. And
he said he doesn't want to talk about.
I doubt they'll learn it on CNN.
He said he doesn't want to talk about. He won't talk about what happened in intelligence briefings.
But right. He shouldn't. It's called an intelligence briefing. Anderson, are you comfortable that?
But if this didn't happen in an intelligence briefing, then you can talk about it. If this wasn't part of the brief,
Were your four journalists in the intelligence briefing? Were the officials who leaked to the media in the intelligence briefing?
But KellyAnne,
intelligence officials and the briefer.
What you're saying doesn't make sense. On the one hand, you're saying our reporting is inaccurate. On the other hand, you're saying you don't know if it was in the intelligence briefing, and you can't say even if you did know, right?
I can tell you that credible news reports today say that it was not in there.
An NBC News report based on one source. An NBC News report based on one source.
And what is yours based on?
Multiple sources, and the New York Times and the Wall Street Journal as well say it.
No, excuse me. You know who the person who put this collection of raw material is, right?
We're not reporting that raw material. We're not reporting that this person. We're not basing our reporting on what this person did. Of course, it was opposition research. CNN is not BuzzFeed. I just wish you guys would acknowledge and just be straightforward. I get why politically it makes sense for you to link CNN with what BuzzFeed did. But as Jake Tapper has repeatedly said on the air, he doesn't approve. He's one of the reporters on this. He certainly doesn't approve of what BuzzFeed did. I certainly would not have dumped all this unsubstantiated allegations. I think it's unfair.
But now that it's out there, CNN's all too happy to refer to it, aren't you?
We're not reporting it. No, we've mentioned none of it on the air. We have not talked about any details on the air.
It's on your website. But anyway, it's on CNN.com. But here's the thing. Now it'll get lots of clicks.
I encourage people to go online.
CNN and BuzzFeed have a lot in common. You both were absolutely convinced and told all of your viewers that Hillary Clinton was going to win this election.
You can't stick to what we're talking about now?
No. This is what we're talking about, because the excitement, the fury about hacking reached a fever pitch after the election results were neither what was expected or desired by CNN, President Obama, Hillary Clinton, and the whole crew. If cybersecurity was such a big priority to this administration and the Democratic Party and its apologists in the media, then why didn't we do more about it over the last 8 years? Why, when 21 million personnel files were hacked of innocent Americans through the Office of Personnel Management by China, President Obama basically gave them a slap on the wrist.
I know you like to pivot. I get it.
Actually real news. That actually happened.
Okay.
That's not unsourced, unnamed.
I guess what you still haven't
answered, Anderson,
is what isn't inaccurate in our reporting? Because you said you weren't in the briefing. You don't know if what we're reporting is true or not. You weren't in the briefing, and I guess you haven't heard anything about what was in the briefing from anybody who was there. Can you deny that what we reported, not what BuzzFeed, all that unsubstantiated stuff, which we're not reporting, what we reported, how can you say it's not true?
I think if you link to something on your website, you're reporting it.
Okay, again, you're not answering the question. How can you say it's not true?
No, hold on. You can't say you're not reporting it if it's on your website, if it's on CNN.
You can't answer this question. What is inaccurate about our reporting?
Here's the answer. If the four intelligence officials that gave the top secret briefing last week that some fools think they should leak to the media, when it's a top secret intelligence briefing for a reason, so that we're all protected, everybody, then why, according to your own report last night, report used as a loose word here, why did they not tell the president-elect about it? Because your own reporting says that there's no confirmation that they briefed him orally. If it was
right,
so
I appreciate you acknowledging that.
And it's worthy, if it's worthy of a CNN screaming headline that became this huge fake news story, then why did they not brief him? They had an opportunity. They were here in Trump Tower. Why didn't they tell him if it was so important? You know what it's important
to?
Politics, intelligence. I have the answer.
We report on what we know and
not intelligence.
We report on what our sources are telling us and what our sources said. We could not get any confirmation of whether or not this was verbally discussed, and we acknowledge
that. And
why
run with it? Why release it first if it's significant and report it sometime enough to be, in the future?
If it's significant enough to be in the briefing documents, then it seems significant. The fact that whether it's not true, for whatever the reason, they decided to have it be in the briefing documents, that is news. If it's significant enough to be in the briefing documents, then it seems significant. The fact that whether it's not true, for whatever the reason, they decided to have it be in the briefing documents, that is news, no?
And what if it's not in the briefing documents, Anderson? What will CNN do?
Well, if our report is wrong, we'll acknowledge that.
Really? Well, heads roll because they didn't after the election when all the polling was
wrong. Are you telling me right now?
But
you've yet to say.
All the chyrons were wrong.
You can't say.
All the consultants were wrong.
You can't say.
All the anchors were wrong.
You're talking about polling during the election, which, yeah, all that data.
I'm asking. I just don't think that you'll clean house if the report is wrong, if there wasn't a two-page appendix, because you haven't cleaned house yet.
What you think and what is true are not necessarily the same thing. So I'm trying to figure out from you what you can say about what is true and what is not. And you cannot take issue with any specific that we have reported. I've yet to hear you say specifically, that is not true.
It's not true.
It's not true that those were in the briefing documents. It's not true that that was. It's not true that that was in any of the briefing documents. You're saying that categorically.
It's true that you have no evidence of it other than unnamed sources who don't have the briefing documents. That's what's true, because they would not have access to the briefing documents.
You don't know who the sources are, but we have multiple sources. And again, this is something also that the New York Times.
Tell them to come forward. Tell them they can have this chair anytime. Tell them to come forward. Why are they unnamed?
This is a red herring.
You're just Democrat.
It's like you've got bright. No, you're trying to distract from my question, which is you do not have the information whether it's true or not.
You can use words like pivot, distract, red herring all you want. The fact is that the media have a 16% approval rating for a reason. It's been earned. And it's crap like this that really undergirds why Donald Trump won. In fact, you're doing him a favor again. This was an anti-elitist election. It was rejection of everybody thinks they know better than people.
I'm just trying
this
to get a sense of what you...
This report is very concerning.
You say it's not true, but you can't say whether it's true or not. I get the anger of the BuzzFeed stuff. I thought that was...
Not
when
angry.
I read that, it was totally unsubstantiated. We're not reporting that. I guess I don't understand... I think I do understand, because I think it's politics for you to try to link all the reporters together. But it seems just unfair and, frankly, disingenuous.
No, actually, very few people came to CNN's defense today. I'm sure you're aware of that.
Well, actually, Shepard Smith on Fox did, which I thought was interesting and actually pretty courageous.
That's a cherry, yeah, right. Well, anybody else on Fox or anybody else? And I don't see people rushing to CNN's defense. I saw a lot of pushback, frankly.
Well,
I haven't talked
to Sean Hannity today. I'm sure you guys have a couple times. But.
Well, you can pick on Fox all you want, but I've been on other networks today. Sean Spicer has. The president-elect gave a press conference in front of over 400 journalists, a credentialed journalist, who wanted to cover this, and they're not out there saying, linking to CNN's report. And there's a reason for that, because it has unnamed, unsourced folks. And you can, so if you say, let me ask you a question, because you're a journalist and I'm not.
Right.
Anderson.
Well, I should point out the New York Times, Wall Street Journal actually matched what our reporting was.
If you say that CNN is not reporting on something, but it's on your website, does that mean CNN's not reporting on it? Because I think they are.
BuzzFeed is
not
on our
your
website.
Show doesn't mean. Okay. The BuzzFeed report, the BuzzFeed story is not linked on your website. It's not mentioned in
the story.
I don't
know. I don't know all of what's on digital program. I'm told it's not, but I don't believe that
it is.
That's, I find it weird that CNN, and frankly, if CNN linked to the BuzzFeed stuff, that seems to me inappropriate. And if CNN does that, I would not support that. But as far as I know, that is not the case. I'm certainly going to check out our website, and I urge people to go to our websites right now and check it out for themselves.
Anderson, do you think that BuzzFeed or anybody else, after months of deciding against publishing specious, scurrilous, unverified, uncorroborated junk in a Democratic opposition research document, do you think they would have released it last night had CNN not preceded it with its own report? I doubt it.
You know what?
There
the last time I read BuzzFeed, I saw a headline that said, like, 10 top sex toys that was going to improve your sex life. I don't read BuzzFeed.
Okay, now you're insulting BuzzFeed.
No, I'm just not interested. I don't read BuzzFeed. So I'm not going to speak for them or defend them. I don't think they should have published unsubstantiated allegations against the president-elect of the United States. I think that's inappropriate.
Well, maybe they would not have had the imprimatur of CNN, the vaunted name of CNN, gone first. You went
so
first.
So your
they
problem
went second.
Is that we reported something based on multiple sources that's then corroborated also by the New York Times and the Wall Street Journal and others
No, not about the two pages. It's also been pushed back by NBC News and others tonight.
NBC News, based on one source, and what they said is that it wasn't verbally presented, and we never said it was.
Anderson, do you think it should have been, though? I mean, if it's worthy of this conversation, do you think it should have been verbally presented?
I can't speak.
No, I'm asking you just as a smart person who loves America.
I'm not going to speak for the intelligence officials on what they chose to brief or not brief.
Okay, but then it's not important, right? Because they were in the room. They could have told
you.
I have
no idea. That's your judgment. I have no idea. We stand by our reporting, which was we don't know whether it was actually verbally briefed. We don't have reporting on that. All we have, based on multiple sources, which CNN stands by 100%, was that this was in the material, not the 35-page salacious, unsubstantiated document that BuzzFeed later put out, but some sort of a summary about it. That's what our reporting was.
So just so we're clear, so that we have good relations with the press here in the Trump White House, if it turns out that the two pages are not true, do not exist somehow, then CNN will take corrective measures about that, because you released first and you'll report later in this instance.
I certainly think they should. I think everybody in this business who stands by the reporting, if they do it wrong, if they get it wrong, they should acknowledge that right away
and admit their mistakes, and I think
that's important.
The point that Sean Spicer and the president-elect were trying to make today is very simple. It's that many outlets refuse to go where CNN went and separately.
No, many outlets refuse to publish a 35-page unsubstantiated document, which is what CNN also did.
They've also refused to say that CNN had this report, quote unquote, I'm using the term liberally, had this report that there was a two-page appendix that somehow said something that was so important to the security of our nation that nobody bothered to brief the president-elect and perhaps even President Obama the day before. Not everybody has the same
sourcing, obviously. You know that. Some people have better sourcing than others. And CNN is standing by their reporting. But I'll tell you, everyone has
unnamed sourcing, though.
Okay.
Unnamed sourcing.
My only point...
This is political. Okay.
First of all, I respect you coming on and talking about this, but my only point that I just want to get across to you is I just don't understand. I think it's unfair to conflate the two, and whatever the reasons y'all are doing that, I'm not sure. I have ideas, but I just don't think that's professional.
You should take that up with other journalists, because those who mentioned this issue at all today mentioned both CNN and BuzzFeed together, in print, on Twitter, on Facebook.
Right. Well,
and
those people, anybody who conflated it as the same reporting, that's inaccurate reporting. Just as what Sean Spicer said is inaccurate.
Those who mentioned this issue at all today mentioned both CNN and BuzzFeed together, in print, on Twitter, on Facebook.
Right. Well, and those people, anybody who conflated it as the same reporting, that's inaccurate reporting, just as what Sean Spicer said is inaccurate.
It wasn't conflated as the same reporting, Anderson. It was conflated as the same series of events that have led to this conversation. But look, the fact is that Donald Trump last week, the president-elect, after he received his intelligence briefing, he came out with a statement. Your viewers, I hope, have seen it. I'm sure they have. I commend them to read it again and again, because he says some things very clearly about who has attempted to hack us, and they continue to attempt. They did successfully hack the DNC, and that he, the president-elect, in moving forward, wants to meet with his own security and intelligence team and ask them for a plan within 90 days of taking office, Anderson, to come up with a plan that will improve cybersecurity enhancements, because it doesn't seem like it was a priority until after people didn't like the election results. And the idea that innocent people had their names dragged through the mud last night should be disconcerting to everyone. These folks who have never been in Prague, people we don't even know, people aren't associated with the campaign.
Right.
You got the party started. A lot of your journalists today feel that way because they were at the press conference and we hear from them. So I just want to give you a friendly piece of advice. Many people feel that CNN went first and BuzzFeed went second, and that with the imprimatur of CNN going first and posting this and then making it a huge centerpiece of TV coverage, that then it allowed a news outlet to go ahead and publish the rest of the story, quote unquote, and it's fake news, as Donald Trump said last night. And I also agree with him; it's a political witch hunt.
So, if CNN reports something and people on Twitter new shady organizations or BuzzFeed or reputable organizations start then reporting other things, we're not. You cannot hold CNN responsible for what other people are doing. They're responsible for what they do. We stand by our reporting 100%. And I guess, I think we both made our points, but I really do appreciate.
I can hold CNN accountable for having the screaming headline that he was briefed on something if he wasn't. That's what it says. It says intelligence chiefs presented Trump with information that Russia efforts to compromise right. him.
Well, it doesn't Where say he was briefed. Evidence? It says that it was presented with information, that there was information in there. In the documents.
In a footnote? No, or sliding it under a gun
You said briefed.
Wrapper?
That's not what the headline just said. So I'm just...
Yeah, well, the implications and the chyrons and the consultants and the people who have been anti-Trump since the beginning and continue to be as he becomes president. I mean, look, Anderson, I think the more important conversation, maybe it's for another time, but let's start it tonight briefly. The more important conversation is we're at a very important inflection point about journalism. What are the standards here? How are we going to cover the new president of the United States? Because I took a little peek at what the headlines about President-elect Obama were 8 years ago. Whew, talk about the world's biggest disconnect. It was basically how he'll rule with excellence. Should President-elect Obama go to Oslo now and pick up his Nobel Peace Prize, or should he wait until after he's sworn in? We get nothing like that. We get no forbearance. We get nothing. We get no respect.
We actually covered Donald Trump's allegations against Donald Trump, against President Obama quite frequently, and interviewed actually Donald Trump about his allegations, completely unproven and fake, against President Obama.
I don't know what that has to do with this. I'm just merely saying 8 years
ago. You're talking about old headlines about President Obama. We ran with that story a lot.
At this time, before he was president-elect, it was basically what will they wear to the inauguration and how historic, in other words, what will his inaugural address be? Why don't we have that conversation? I'm happy to talk to you about that, but we can't.
Well,
when CNN and BuzzFeed and others are trying to release information sequentially on the same night and it all gets picked up and gets looped together, and you know that. I was on several shows this morning. Our incoming chief of staff, Reince Priebus, was. We had a press conference today with the president-elect. Right. And it all gets
I understand other
together.
People
you may not like it.
I understand other people loop things together, but we are not discussing the details of what BuzzFeed dumped onto the internet. That's not you haven't
well,
heard that on
CNN did today. Well, and I guarantee they will tonight, probably on a show that runs after yours.
We have been very conscientious in not discussing the details, the completely unsubstantiated and increasingly false, apparently, details of what was being reported by BuzzFeed, or what was not only being reported, just being dumped onto the internet by BuzzFeed. And we're not going to do it tonight, certainly not on my program. But
it's all fake news. And let me just say,
well,
Anderson, it's
not all
I really
fake
think
news.
That
I mean, that's just well, disingenuous.
In that report, yes, it's all fake news. And people keep using the word dossier, using some fancy French word is going to imbue it with credibility. It's an internet report. It is not an intelligence report. It's a collection of stuff that came from political operatives.
Yes, I agree.
Who wanted a different candidate to win.
We agree on this.
But Anderson, look, if a business doesn't do well some year, they usually clean house. They usually get rid of the people who embarrassed them, who didn't meet their projection goals, who said things that just weren't true and made no sense. And I just don't see that at CNN and other places. I mean, how are we going to move forward and have a great relationship with major news organizations if everything just sounds and looks and seems the same? The chyrons, the pundits,
but to be honest, my job is not to have a great relationship with you. My job, I like you personally, my job, and I respect you, and I respect anybody who is in the public arena and putting themselves out there and is a public servant, as you all are. And I respect the president-elect enormously for all he's done and all I hope he's going to do. But the job of the press is not to be buddy buddies and hang out socially
with
everybody.
How about be
fair? I agree.
Well,
be
well
fair
gosh,
and
that
be
certainly has been the case for President Obama.
I've never been to the White House to hang out socially.
But a lot of folks have.
I don't go to the White House Correspondent Dinner. I went once. I'm like, I'm never going again. I don't want to hang out socially with these people. That's not my job. But this is a larger conversation. I'm happy to have it to you because I do.
Well, it is. And Anderson, just briefly, that's right. But Mike Pence put it best today, our vice president-elect. He said, in introducing our president-elect Donald Trump, he said that we all support a fair and free press. But with freedom comes responsibility. And he's absolutely right. And I think people should not do this rush to judgment, have conclusions in search of evidence. that right. really confuse the viewers and the readers.
I totally agree with that. We're on the same page on that. And KellyAnne Conway, as always, I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Well, throughout the interview, you heard KellyAnne Conway repeatedly claim that CNN linked to the BuzzFeed story that the Trump team and many others are taking exception with, the BuzzFeed story, which we have not reported the details on. You also heard me say repeatedly that that is simply not true. About 20 minutes after that interview, before we went on air, KellyAnne Conway tweeted this screenshot of our reporting and what she claims, again, claims is a link to BuzzFeed in that article. Now, just as a matter of fact, because facts do actually matter, it is not a link to BuzzFeed. It links to a story by CNN's Dylan Byers about the controversy. And his piece, which I've read, does not link to BuzzFeed, nor does it lay out the unverified, unsubstantiated allegations that the Trump people rightly are objecting to. It does mention Trump attorney Michael Cohen. That's only because Michael Cohen publicly denied what BuzzFeed's, his mention in the BuzzFeed, I don't even want to call it reporting, the document dump. There is no link to BuzzFeed, full stop, hasn't been on CNN.